Hi, this is the Bet Central podcast. Let's make some profit.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Bet Central Formula One podcast. My name is Sean Parker. I've got my regular co-host, Mary-Anne Wakefield, back. She was at the Simola Hill Climb last weekend, just catching up a little bit before we started the recording. Sounds like you had a fantastic time.
It was amazing as usual. Some surprise winners, but yeah, great as usual. Next year is the 15th year, so I do, you know, everybody needs to go out and enjoy it.
Yeah, it's a really fantastic motorsport event that happens in Eisner, beautiful part of the country. And if you were a motorsport head or a car fundi, you got to go. It's just the cars on show, incredible. And it's nice to get up close and personal as well. And I loved your pit walk videos and your interviews with all the drivers. It was really cool. But yeah, let's get back to Formula One. You were saying that you were so bummed that you didn't see Lando's first win live, but I'm sure, you know, you caught up with everything. I mean, just what a fantastic performance by him. Let's just chat a little bit, like Mary-Anne, about the upgrades that McLaren did bring to Miami. And is that ultimately what gave him the best chance of winning?
Yeah, I definitely think so. You know, they were probably in the beginning of the year lacking some pace. Lando and Oscar have been riding the car very well, driving the car well. But this time around, we see that with the upgrades, and Oscar's going to get it this time in Imola, so full upgrade for the both cars now, definitely gave them the edge. You know, Piastri was taken out a bit, but Lando just kept on going. And what I liked is that sometimes when you watch the races, they start dropping back because the pace isn't there. But he was able to maintain all the time. And we did say in the last pod, it's just a matter of time before Lando wins. And yeah, I think McLaren has a winning formula now. Let's just stay where it is.
Yeah. A lot of critics out there saying, you know, calling him no win Norris. He said at the beginning of the year that they were gonna, that the car was capable of winning races. And it just shows, you know, they are part of this team where there's a belief, but not only that, the people at the factory, the team boss, Zach Brown, Andreas Steyer, absolutely brilliant the way that he's taking the team on, becoming team principal, obviously, about a year and a half ago, I think. Interested to see what Piastri and Norris can do this weekend. And talking about this weekend, so we are previewing the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix at one of the sport's most iconic circuits, Imola. We didn't have a race here last year because of the floods. In fact, Formula One raised about €1 million for flood relief victims this time last year. So the last race was in 2022. And we were just checking before we started the pod. It was a 1-2 for Red Bull, Max Verstappen and Sergio Perez. That was obviously during one of Max's dominant periods. And the interesting thing is Lando Norris finished third in that race. So yeah, that was prior to them getting that huge upgrade in Austria during that season. But, you know, we're around about that time now. Obviously, we mentioned where McLaren have brought upgrades. Oscar Piastri getting that full upgrade for Imola this weekend. So, and you also alluded to the fact that Ferrari are bringing upgrades as well. So, all of the big hitters are there. And so, it's going to be interesting to kind of see what happens this weekend. But, yeah, let's chat about Imola. Quite a emotional weekend it could be as well, because of the 30th anniversary of Ayrton Senna's death not too long ago. In fact, I think last week or a week and a half ago. This is obviously, yeah, very close to people's hearts in terms of where Senna passed away. Let's chat about the track. Imola, beautiful, obviously in the Italian countryside, but yeah, in terms of the specs of the track, what can we expect?
Yeah, so as you said, it's a beautiful track. We're back in Europe now for a few races. 63 laps, 4.909 kilometers, so almost a 5K circuit length, 309 kilometers race distance, so almost like Cape Town to Musselbay kind of distance they're riding. 19 corners, one DRS zone, which is strange because normally we have two or three, but this track is a fast track. We also have the, you know, the famous corners, and there were a lot of corners on this track, or a lot of areas on this track, which were dangerous. And that's how Ayrton and Roland passed away in 1994. So they changed a lot of the corners into sort of chicanes and tried to slow down the track a bit. Turn one is like super fast, and then at one point in the track, the cars have to slow down and shoot out again. So it's a very fun track. It is a fun track. It's an interesting track. Charles Leclerc in 2022 in one of the chicanes lost it and went into the wall. So you've got to be really careful. It is a bit difficult to overtake. I think last time in 2022, only 22 overtakes. But of course, the cars have evolved. They're different, you know, from then. So let's see. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, we're hoping for some closer racing. Definitely more overtakes than 22. In fact, like in comparison to, you know, like the race that we've seen this season, that's almost, yeah, on the low side. But yeah, if there's one thing that we can expect, Mary-Anne, from tracks in Italy, is that they are super fast. I mean, we think about Monza, the Temple of Speed. Imola is just another track like that, fast and flowing. In terms of the setup for this weekend, what are the teams going for?
So it's a high downforce track. The teams are going to be running, obviously, a high downforce package. It should suit most teams. I think most teams are quite comfortable with that now at the moment. You know, McLaren used to have an issue, but of course the car over the last two, three races, we can see they're much better now. I think Aston also should be okay. Mercedes is also coming with a big upgrade. But yeah, we know for them, they are lacking pace. They're all over with the car. So I think they may struggle.
Yeah. Do you think it's a case of McLaren knowing exactly where the problem areas of the MCL 38 are and addressing those things, whereas perhaps in comparison to Mercedes, they've got so many areas where they need to focus on, where they still don't know, where they're still grappling with exactly how to set up the car, or, you know, is this part working? Should we try these things, that they're not able to really bring a car to a Grand Prix that they feel comfortable with, because it still lacks in certain areas?
Yeah, it's so difficult. For example, Lewis was saying he's trying different setups. So from the Friday in practice, he does one setup. The Saturday, he does another setup, and the car is completely different. With McLaren, they know a problem area, and they work on that area, and the car sort of just flows from there. But with Mercedes, it's almost like they work on one area, and then everything else gets kicked out. So there's no sort of synergy or consistency. So it's so difficult for them. So, yeah, I think they're really grappling with too many issues at once, where the other teams know, okay, we need to focus on our pace. We're pushing everything into pace. And then the car will still be reliable. That's, you know, Merck is really having a problem with that.
One aspect of this weekend's race that all the teams will be quite relieved about is the fact that it's not a sprint race. Obviously, we had two consecutive sprint GP weekends, China and then in Miami. And obviously, Mary-Anne, that means that teams only have really one free practice for them to receive data, to try something ahead of the weekend's competitive racing. Do you think Imola then brings with just that bit of as I said, like relief, knowing that they've got three practice sessions, they can try a few different things, they can do long runs, they can do short runs, and ultimately just get them in a better fitting for the Grand Prix on Sunday?
Yeah, I think, you know, most every year, so the teams, the big teams, do bring upgrades to Imola. And I think because it's not a sprint race, it definitely gives them time to test different setups. When you're in a sprint race, you have that 45-minute practice. It's impossible to test your setups and let it go on the car. It's almost like you're going blind into a sprint race, really. So I think now with all the upgrades that are coming, they're able to really make sure that on Sunday, the car is race ready.
Okay, so coming into this weekend's races, I guess it's all about, can McLaren maintain the performance that we saw in Miami? Or, you know, is it a case of Red Bull reacting to what they saw McLaren do on the track? And also Ferrari have, you know, they've got, I guess, added impetus because the race is in Italy. You know, it's one of their home races. The support is there. The Tifosi will be out in full, you know, in the crazy numbers again. Who's looking as the strongest package and team going into this weekend?
So right now, I think McLaren, you know, obviously Red Bull is a strong team. I just think last week they had issues. Well, most of the teams had issues with the tires. It was very hot in Miami. It's now much cooler in Europe. And Red Bull always extracts most of their tires. So I think they are race ready, irrespective, you know. The next team, I think McLaren. And then I do think, you know, I don't know. So for some reason, Miami didn't suit Ferrari. They were just didn't have a good weekend. But we are back on, you know, a normal track now. And that's what suits their car. So I definitely think... And, you know, Ferrari headquarters is down the road. So I do think they are bringing all of it. And I think definitely McLaren and Ferrari are going to be up against each other, taking that fight to Red Bull.
Let's just turn our attention away from the front runners for a moment and chat about Aston Martin and Mercedes. Obviously, Aston Martin, one of the few teams that also uses Mercedes engines. What has been your feeling about Fernando Alonso and Lance Stroll's performances over the past couple of weeks? What do they need to do to kind of get themselves back to the point where Alonso was scoring points, you know, consistently last season? Does he not feel comfortable with the car? Has he said anything?
So, you know, Alonso's still managing to get the points in the top 10. He definitely hasn't been out of the top 10. Again, Lance. Alonso is, you know, he's a dark horse. He's all over the place. One week he's in the top 10, like last week was 17. It's so difficult to, you know, really predict where Lance is going to be because he's just everywhere. I kind of feel like Alonso is really pulling that whole team together. I do think they actually, even though they use a Mercedes-Benz engine, they are in a much better space than Mercedes. Their car achieves much more than Mercedes. I do think, you know, Alonso with his experience, I do see him sitting like midfield. I think he can do well. Their car just requires pace. He has said it a few times on the radio when you can hear he's getting irritated. He's like, I just can't go faster. Or he's like, there's no pace, man. So I do think once they sort that out, they just need him to give him the pace. He's an excellent driver. He can do, you know, he can literally take on anything. I think they're going to be very midfield this race.
Yeah, I agree with you. The one thing about Alonso, when he has a quick car underneath him, Mary-Anne, he's able to just bang out performances and, you know, get into the podium. I mean, we saw that at the beginning of last season now. Absolutely fantastic it was. And just quickly touching on Mercedes, the factory team, it's like there's so many news stories about, you know, Toto Wolff going after Max, and obviously with Adrian Newey becoming a free agent from beginning of next year, there's talk about, you know, do Mercedes need him? But the matter of facts are, at the moment, they need to be scoring points. They need to be scoring more points than they are at the moment. Because they want to earn, you know, and hopefully like receive the most prize money at the end of the season for them to be able to develop, the car for next year. And, you know, there are obviously all of these other things that come into play. But the two drivers, I mean, George Russell finished fourth at the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix 2 years ago. Do you see a repeat of that happening?
Definitely not. You know, the car is so unreliable. It's almost like it's taking a brand new car to every track. So it's so difficult for us as, you know, watching it all the time, because it's like we get a different car at every track. So there's no consistency where we can say, you know, for example, Lewis is a great driver. So we know he can go well into the corners. He can do this and that and that. But the car keeps on failing them. So it's so hard to predict if they're going to have a good race or not. You think they are. They spend all the time in the sim, all kinds of things. Yeah, I see George has not been very vocal this season for some reason, and he's sitting back quite a bit. I think he really is struggling with the car, but he's not saying it as much as Lewis is. And I definitely feel you can see the frustration of Toto. It's, you know, they've had a winning formula all the time, and now they're just, you know, dead in the water. So I don't think Mercedes will be right up there. I think they're going to be behind Aston this time.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's get into our predictions. Mary-Anne, over one lap, who do you see taking pole position on Saturday?
I'd love to say Max, but yeah, I kind of feel maybe Charles Leclerc is going to give it to us, hoping.
Yeah, he's obviously, you know, he has a great record in his career in terms of grabbing pole position. Yeah, let's see if Ferrari are able to match and better the pace of the front two in terms of Red Bull and McLaren. And then for the race on Sunday, who do you see on the podium?
I see Max, and I see Leclerc and Norris. I do okay. Definitely feel, and not just because Norris won last week. He's been building this every race, and we've been saying he's getting closer and closer to that podium. I definitely see him on the podium. I do see Charles. I think this track suit Charles better than Sainz, and of course Max. I'm sure Red Bull sorted out the issues.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much for previewing the race with me. It's going to be exciting, and thankfully it's also at a decent time for us, being in a similar time zone. So yeah, looking forward to this weekend's race. Great that you know, the race is back on the calendar, obviously after what happened last year. Yeah, have a fantastic week and enjoy the race.
Thanks, Sean. You too.
See ya.